There was a time when anyone interested in finding out about their family history would have come to this wonderful place here on the banks of the River Thames. It's Somerset House. It was here that the national records of births, deaths and marriages were kept. They've moved now to Kew, but anyway, most people do their research sat in front of a computer screen. Nowadays, you're more likely to come here for a lovely meal or to visit the art gallery. But still, somehow, Somerset House is synonymous with discovering our heritage. The interest in discovering where we are from, the rock from which we're hewn, continues to grow. It's a way of trying to understand why we are the way we are, and even perhaps what we are meant to be. One of the purposes behind the Roots Conference was to discover a little bit more about our Salvation Army history and see how that could positively influence the kind of Salvation Army we are for this day and age. Now, if it's the National Record Office that we turn to discover our family history, then it's the Army's Heritage Centre that we turn to find out our Army DNA. In August of last year, I took over responsibility for coordinating the Salvation Army's response to the evil of human trafficking in the UK. And one of the very first things that I did was to reread this book, Maiden Tribute. The title was inspired by some articles published in 1883, written by W.T. Stead, the editor of the Pall Mall Gazette. He was joined by Bramwell and Florence Booth and Josephine Butler to expose white slave traffic. In 1885, with the help of Rebecca Jarrett, a converted brothel keeper, 13-year-old Eliza Armstrong was purchased for the sum of £5 to prove how easy it was to procure young girls for the purpose of prostitution. W.T. Stead and Rebecca Jarrett were found guilty of kidnapping a minor and served time in jail. Well now, this is the prison uniform that W.T. Stead wore during his time in jail, and apparently he would put it on for one day every year after that. Through the Armstrong case, it was established that the Salvation Army was absolutely committed to the fight against this form of modern-day slavery. And the publicity that the case created resulted in the age of consent being raised from 13 to 16 and new legislation strengthening the laws against forced prostitution. When Josephine Butler was looking for others with whom to fight the cause of right against wrong, she said, "Nothing but a mighty spiritual power permeating a well-considered, wisely organised scheme will prevail." And she concluded, "In the Salvation Army is that wonderful spiritual power." Wow, now that's some heritage they've left us.